Hey everyone, my name is Sherlyn and welcome back to Keyword Tool, where we aim to make keyword research as easy as ABC. If you're new to keyword research, Keyword Tool, or even curious about how to find the best practices and methods to find the best keywords, then this video is going to help you. By the end of this video, I'm going to make sure that you understand what search volume metric means and how to find a list of keywords that's going to be super profitable to your business and website. And of course, please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe to our channel so that you would have more updated content on Keyword Tool. So, what is keyword search volume? Keyword search volume represents the number of searches for a particular keyword during a selected time frame. The number of searches is usually on an average value. The most popular metric is the average monthly search volume, which you can normally find in Google Keyword Planner and other keyword research tools. So, what does it mean for SEO? The keyword search volume is one of the most important metric when it comes to keyword research. It helps to estimate the website's traffic's potential when it comes to optimizing for keywords. Many SEOs tend to focus their efforts solely on this metric when it comes to keyword research. It truly is an important value when it comes to keyword research, but it shouldn't be the only metric that you should be focusing on. And I'll definitely explain more in one of our other videos. How is keyword search volume calculated? In general, there are two main sources of keywords that you should know of. The first one would be the Google data, and the second one is Clickstream data. So, what is Google data? The search volume as we know it is calculated by Google. Most of the keyword research tools use most of the data that is garnered by Google Keyword Planner. However, in 2016, there are much restrictions when it comes to extracting data because Google has limited its access and provided only range data for people or users that doesn't spend much money on ads. Another important factor that you should know of is keyword clustering, also called as close variant keywords. What this means is that Google topically clusters similar keywords, especially long-tail keywords. So you might be wondering, what is Clickstream data? Clickstream data is normally collected via browser extensions, plugins, and other applications. Normally, they would request your permission to collect certain data before you install them. The data is then aggregated from all permitted sources, and various companies buys it to use it further. Hence, other SEO tools could use this as their source for search volume data. Now here comes a little debate. Would you go for Google data or Clickstream data? Using Keyword Tool for your keyword research process would mean that you would have 100% accurate Google keyword search volume data. As we know, Google owns an amazing database, hence getting keywords directly from Google would be extremely reliable when it comes to your keyword research. And it gives an amazing understanding of how your keywords has performed over time. Only a small amount of people has this kind of extensions and apps installed on your computer, which means this source may not be as reliable as we think it would be. Now, search volume data is a very important element when it comes to keyword research. In order to target the most profitable keywords, you need to know how many people are exactly searching for your particular keyword. Hence, Keyword Tool is here for you for that purpose. Now, I'm pretty sure you have a really burning question. How can I exactly find the set of keywords that's going to be potentially beneficial to my business and my niche? Because let's be real, who doesn't want valuable website traffic constantly to their website? But how? How are you going to find keywords that's going to be so valuable to your SEO that could help you with your website traffic? Well, first, you need to identify relevant search behavior of your target audience. In other words, you gotta dig in a little deeper and understand what people are actually searching on Google or other search engines. And the following steps are going to benefit you to find out exactly what keywords that you should be focusing on for your business and niche. The first step is to have a brainstorm session. You can do it with your team or even with yourself. Now take this time to really understand on what really resonates with your business, customers, and even your niche. And if you're working remotely, no worries. Here's a tip. You can start using Google Documents, Google Sheets. Those are great platforms where you can start populating keywords that are relevant to your business and niche. Step 2. Create a gross list of keywords. So now, what do I mean by that? Once you've done your brainstorm session, where everything is all laid on, create a list that you want to really focus on, and that gross list is going to be something that you're going to do further research on. Which comes to step 3, expand your keywords. Now, I love using this method to identify other potential keywords that I may not even thought of. Now, how do I expand my keywords? Here's a pro tip that can actually help you. Normally, I would use synonyms to actually find out what other keywords that I may have missed off. You can easily go to thesaurus.com, type in your specific term, and then you'll be able to see what other synonyms or keywords that are related to your C term. Or you could use Keyword Tool to expand your keywords list. Now, Keyword Tool Pro has amazing features with question feature, preposition feature, related keyword features. All these keywords are created to help you expand your keywords list, diving deep on what is important. Now, the fourth step is to perform a keyword search volume analysis. Now that you have your long list of keywords, you could easily copy and paste that list onto the check search volume feature, where you'll be able to get the average monthly search volume in a single click. And the fifth step is to actually check the competition. Now that you know its exact search volume, you would want to also understand how competitive these keywords are, whether is it worth it for you to buy ads for this particular keyword. This metric helps you to find out how many people are actually competing for your set of keywords. This set of keywords will definitely take more of your time, so it should be worth it. But do consider that before trying to rank for this set of keywords. And finally, the sixth step is that you could start implementing your strategies on your SEO effort. Now that you have a well-informed understanding of your search behavior, you could start implementing relevant keywords into your SEO strategy. With that set list of keywords that you have, you can now start optimizing your keywords effectiveness month-to-month to see which to focus on and which to eliminate from that list, and start prioritizing on what truly matters to your SEO effort. And the best thing about using Keyword Tool is that the data will be reflected as and when Google updates its data. So when Google updates its data, Keyword Tool would also have its data updated. As simple as that. While I understand there are other tools out there that could help you with your keyword research process, I'd like to add that Keyword Tool provides 100% accurate Google data. Yep, that's right. It's coming directly from its source. Not only that, Keyword Tool allows you to check search volume in bulk up to thousands of keywords in a single day. Now, if you would love to have Keyword Tool as part of your keyword research process, or rather you would like me to explain a bit more about how Keyword Tool could help you and your business, feel free to drop us an email right here. Or you could schedule a demo call with me particularly so that I could walk you through the entire process. Sign up now and get started immediately. Oh, did I mention? If you sign up with Keyword Tool Pro, not only would you get access to check search volume data for Google, but you'll have access to YouTube, eBay, Amazon, Google Play, and even Twitter. And that's gonna give you a more holistic approach to how you can actually understand the behavior of your customers when it comes to doing keyword research. Now, I hope this video has been helpful to help you identify the list of keywords that's truly important so that it could help you drive profitable website traffic. Once again, don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe to our channel. I'd love to share more content with you so that you can get updated on the best practices on keyword research with Keyword Tool. Thank you so much for watching till the very end, and I'll see you soon.